Welcome everyone to the Fender for Cloud in the Field. This is one of those episodes that is another follow-up from Ignite. We had a lot of follow-up episodes from Ignite that took place November 2023. And this here will be the first episode of 2024. So Happy New Year for you all that are watching this episode. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel, aka link below. Today we have someone that has been in this show before, and she is bringing some interesting news about a feature that we released in GA recently. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to my friend Ortal Parpara. Ortal, thank you for being on.
Thank you, Yuri. It's my pleasure.
Welcome back. I'm glad to have you here again. This time to talk about secret scanning for virtual machining. So before we go to a little deeper in the details, tell us a little bit, what is secret scanning in this context of the Fender for Cloud?
Okay, so I'll start by explaining the problem that we want to solve. Customers have many exposed plaintext secrets on their virtual machines, and that can happen because of lack of awareness. Like, some organizations may not be aware of the risks that it poses on their organization to have exposed secrets. It can happen because of lack of discovery tools, that it's hard to detect all those exposed secrets on the machines. It can happen also because there's a trade-off between having secrets on machines that can access easily to cloud resources, but then again, it poses some security risk. So we're here to solve this issue for organizations to detect those secrets and to mitigate the risk of lateral movement that they pose. So we do it using the cloud APIs, and we capture all the exposed secrets that the users have on their machines, and we display it to the customers for mitigation.
And this is done via agentless capabilities, right? So how that agentless capability really work behind the scenes with the secret scanning?
Okay, so the agentless capability is works by we take a snapshot of the disk of the virtual machine. We do it out of bounds of the virtual machine, so it doesn't affect the performance of the machine. And we scan the snapshot. We send the metadata to Defender for Cloud, and then we delete the snapshot. So all the information is deleted right after the scan. In addition to that, the scan happens in the same region as the VM, so it is also compliant in that manner. So the information never leaves the region while it is being scanned, and only the metadata continues onwards.
One question about this feature: is this something that is on by default, or do I have to onboard enable something?
Okay, so that is a good question. In order to onboard to this feature, all the customers have to do is to be enrolled to the plan of DCSPM or Service Plan P2, and then turn on the agentless scanning. And the secret scanning is part of this feature, so it's a very easy onboarding.
Okay, so is this feature is available via Defender CSPM as well as Defender for Server P2, but you still have to toggle an option to get this capability, correct?
Correct, yes, you have to turn it on.
Okay, and once it's on and we do this initial onboarding and scanning process, how does the secret detection work?
So the secrets are found in the file system, and we support the vast majority of the file types. We search for tokens, for keys, connection strings, passwords that can lead to cloud resources. And then we extract the metadata about these secrets. And then we later show it to the customer with the cloud context of where we found those secrets.
This is a very interesting capability because it really creates this connection of our whole Synapse strategy, giving these additional insights to our customers. This is one of the artifacts that we scan. Now, there are many secrets detections. The question that I believe customers will have as they start, you know, using this feature more and more is how can the customer prioritize the secret detections? There is any guidance on that?
Yes. So first of all, once we scan the machines, the amount of findings can be overwhelming. So the first thing we do is that we give rich metadata on each secret. We show the timestamps of the file and where the secret was found. So for example, when it was last accessed, we show the target resource of it. And if it exists on the cloud, you can also see an edge connecting to it. And I will show it later in my demo.
All right, cool.
We show the cloud context about the containing resource and about the vulnerabilities it may have, and also the number of secrets that was found on each resource, or which type of secrets can be found most. So you can use all these, all this information and all this context about the secrets in order to decide how to prioritize and handle the specific secret.
This capability doesn't really have any effect on performance, right? Because a lot of people, sometimes every time that we talk about scanning, they immediately think, oh, this is going to affect my VM's performance or something. That doesn't happen with this capability, correct?
No, it doesn't happen at all. We use the cloud API in order to take a snapshot of the disk without interrupting the machine's normal running process. We scan the snapshot and then we delete the snapshot. So it's not scanning inside the VM. So it's really not like an agent that is installed on the machine.
And the last question before we jump to the demo, is this feature available in Azure only, or is it a multi-cloud capability already?
Okay, yes. So it's a multi-cloud capability. I didn't mention it before in the onboarding, but you can onboard either a subscription or a security connector. And we scan machines in Azure, AWS, and GCP, and it's available for all clouds. We also find secrets that can lead to different clouds in the environment.
Awesome. That's perfect, because at Ignite, we release our cross-cloud attack path capability, right? So that definitely helps to identify if a threat actor is jumping from one resource in one cloud to the other. Perfect. So let's jump to the demo. Show us how this works.
Cool. So I'll start by showing the recommendation. This is the recommendation for Azure. And as I can see the affected resources here, and on the bottom of the page, I can see that the findings are aggregated per secret type, and I can see to which resources it has an effect on. And if I click on one of the secrets, I can see the specific remediation to this secret type. So each secret type has its own remediation process. And when I click on one of the resources, I can also see elaborated information on the secret. So I can see the attack path, I can see the path in the machine where the secret was found, and some information about it when it was last accessed. So this is via the recommendation. Another thing I want to show is exactly like you mentioned, Yuri. This is a cross-cloud attack path that was created with secrets. So we can see here a GCP compute instance that is exposed to the internet. It contains an SSH private key that we found in our scans that leads to an AWS EC2 instance, which contains an AWS RDS connection string that was found with the secret scanning, which then leads to an AWS RDS DB instance, which has sensitive data. So this elaborated attack path was found with two secrets that we found both in GCP and AWS, and really shows us a path from one cloud to another to sensitive data of the customer. Another blade that really shows the context of each secret is the resource health blade. We can get to it from the inventory blade of Defender for Cloud. I can see here all the file paths on the machines that we found secrets on. And if I click on one of these rows, I can see all the information about the secret. And if other resources would contain this secret, then I would also see them here. So I can really see the full context of the secret, where it leads to. I can easily track this target resource. You can also see that there is an attack path column here that says that these secrets actually produce an attack path, and I should handle them, maybe prioritize to handle them first. And the last blade I want to show is the Cloud Security Explorer. We created this Security Explorer shows the whole context of the cloud map. And we created here a few templates for the customers to use, 1, 2, 3, and 4, that show easily the secrets that are contained by VMs and that lead to other resources in the cloud. So you won't have to build the query yourself. You can easily just click on it. And then you can see this is, for example, a query about SSH private keys that lead from virtual machines to other virtual machines. And if I search it, I can see in the results all the machines that contain an SSH key that can later authenticate to another resource. You can see that here it's also cross-cloud. So this is from GCP to AWS and from Azure to AWS, for example. And if I click on one of these rows, I can see elaborated information about the files associated with the secret, so exactly where the secret was found on the machine. So if I want to mitigate, I can just access the path and delete it. And when I click on the secret node, I can see more elaborated details about the secret. So first I see which resources contain this secret. Okay, I see that this secret can be found on the machine that we just saw and another machine in GCP. And I can also see for SSH, which authorized keys files contain the public key for the secret, which means to which resources I can identify with the secret. So it really gives the full context of each secret, and each secret type has its own unique general details here that you can see the context about.
Ortal, that looks great. I love the fact that we are surfacing this information in different places, which allow customers to have different options to query. The visualization of the Cloud Security Explorer is fantastic because you can dig in and customize the search. One last question before we wrap up here is, if I'm a new customer and I just enabled Defender CSPM and I just onboarded this capability, usually how long it takes for us to start populating this information? It takes, what, 24 hours maybe?
Yes, up to 24 hours from the moment you turn on the agentless scanning until all the machines in your environment are then scanned and you can see the results.
Excellent. Well, congratulations for the GA on this feature. I know that the whole team worked pretty hard to get this out. Do you have any final thoughts or considerations that you want to share?
I mean, we did work hard on this feature, and I really think that it gives full context on the cloud resources and the environment. And you can see it in a few blades that definitely give the option to remediate when necessary.
Excellent. Thank you very much for taking the time to put this together and to join and share your thoughts about this feature. I truly appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Yuri, for having me.
All right, everyone, this is a wrap for today's episode. Please make sure to subscribe. If you are not a subscriber, go to our playlist at Microsoft Security Channel and the AKA link below. Hit the bell to receive notifications when new episodes are uploaded. As I said, we have a lot more coming up about specific features that were released at Ignite, some follow-up sessions. So stay tuned, we have more to come. See you next time.